God never wanted us to have to work our way out of this. He already did the work for us. Guys, we need to understand this part. It starts with Him and it ends with Him. And in the middle of that is our submission and our faith. First thing I need you guys to understand. The first thing is, you need to understand that Christ came to this earth to set us free. To set us free from the bondage of sin. To set us free from the wrath of God. So we could actually live for Him. See, before He came and did that, we were slaves to sin. Now when we place our faith in Him, we're free from sin. And people hear that and they get like upset with that, but that's what the Bible says. Galatians 5:1, for freedom Christ has set us free. Stand therefore and do not submit again to the yoke of slavery. See, what are we submitting to? That's what it comes down to. Where is your faith at? What do you submit yourself to? What do you submit your members to? Like it says in Romans. In Romans, all over Romans, it talks about us being free from sin. Guys, we are free. Romans 6:22, but now that you have been set free from sin and have become slaves of God, the fruit you get leads to sanctification and its end, eternal life. So when we put our faith in Christ and we believe in what He did for us, we trust in Him. We're set free from sin. Now there's a process called sanctification. We start to renew our minds to the truth. Because in John 8, it says, then you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free. So we got to know the truth. We got to start to know Jesus, because He is the truth. His word is truth. We got to start to renew our mind. And then the freedom starts to just take place because our faith is in Christ. God never wanted us to have to work our way out of this. He already did the work for us. Guys, we need to understand this part. It starts with Him and it ends with Him. And in the middle of that is our submission and our faith. It's all in what He did. He did the work for us already. We're free. Renew your mind to that truth. Submit to Him. And then listen to what He's telling you to do after that. Because the Holy Spirit then is going to lead you in what He wants you to do. He's given you His grace to walk in it. He might want you to cut people off. He might want you to start going to church. He might want you to get some accountability around you. People that you can walk through this with and grow with. He's going to lead you. But that's all by His grace. We need to submit to Him. We need to submit to Him, guys. That's where it all started with me. I was running for a while. For a while I was running. Because I didn't want to submit. I didn't want to submit to Him. I didn't trust Him. But I believed in Him. See, the Bible says that even the demons believe and tremble. Right? It's not enough to just believe. We have to trust Him with our lives. That's why I'm putting on this song, I Will Trust. Because it's all about where our faith and trust is. It's not enough to just believe that He is God. We need to surrender and submit and trust Him with our lives and then walk with Him, deny ourselves. Let Him lead us. So this starts with humility. Step one says, we admitted we were powerless over our addictions and our compulsive behaviors, that our lives have become unmanageable. So first things first, we have to understand that we can't do this in our own strength. We need help. We need God to set us free. We can't do the work. The Bible says that nobody is righteous. Not one person on this earth without Jesus and His sacrifice is righteous. We can't do it in our own strength. So just get it out of your head. Lay it down. Understand and humble yourself before you get humbled. Be humble before you get humbled. Because we can't do it in our own strength. That's step one. Understand that you need help. We all need help. It's not just you. We all need help. We all need Him. Now, the blessing in that is when we humble ourselves and we come to Him, addictions break, bondages break, sin breaks off of us, we become renewed, we take on His moral standards, and we have the grace now to walk in that. He makes us better people, right? But also, it really helps when you have a drug problem. You know, the gospel will completely destroy any drug problem. Once you understand what He did for us and you really believe it, it's over. It's so over. And now you actually believe that He's leading you out of it. There's no way that it can stand. It's done. God is with you, fighting for you. You think any enemy or any darkness coming against the creator of the universe is going to stand? No shot. But we got to start with step one. We got to humble ourselves. We need Him. And that's what I want to focus on right now. We need God in every situation. It's not just drugs. We need God in every single situation. See, I was just telling somebody recently. I was like, yeah, I went through a lot with my drug problem, with my drug addiction. But you know what? Like, I'm really grateful for it because it brought me to my knees. It brought me to this place where I actually found God. And I have this real relationship with God. That now all the other stress in my life, because I still have things going on that would have really caused me to go down a deeper hole in my addiction. I probably would have died because of the stress that I have now. But now I know where to take my stress. Now I know how to have peace. The Bible says, bring your anxieties and your cares to God. Because He cares for you. Bring your stress and all your anxieties to Him. Lay it down at His feet. And then when you give Him your anxiety and your stress, it's like He's just handing you peace in exchange. And it's such a beautiful transition. It's such a beautiful thing that we have with Him. So yeah, I'm grateful for my drug addiction. I'm grateful for the things that I went through. Because I wouldn't be able to stand without knowing how to deal with these things. Now I have a way with Him to get through anything. Because I'm founded on the rock. And when the storm comes, my house doesn't fall. I'm founded on Christ. I got God fighting my battles for me. And you come to this place where you're like, take everything. You surrender it all. You're like, Lord, take everything. Just give me You. See, this declaration that they're saying in this song right now is so powerful. When you actually mean this, take the world, give me Jesus. There's nothing like it, man. You're walking in true freedom at that point. True freedom. True purpose. Nothing could hold you down. Everything has to go. Because when we walk by the Spirit, we won't gratify the desires of the flesh. I feel like I say that all the time. But I feel like a lot of the church doesn't believe that. We focus too much on sin. We can't be sin conscious. We have to be righteousness conscious. Let's focus on what He did for us and how we can be free. Let's just stay focused there and see where He takes us. Praise You, Lord. So 1 Peter 5:6 says, humble yourselves, therefore, under the mighty hand of God, so that at the proper time He may exalt you. So we come to this place where we're humble before Him. We know we need Him. We know we can't do this on our own. We know that our lives have become unmanageable. Our addictions are getting way out of control. We can't control them. We need to lay them down. We need help. So when we do that, God will exalt us. James 4:6 says, but He gives more grace. Therefore, it says, God opposes the proud, but gives grace to the humble. So it's a promise in Scripture that when we humble ourselves before Him, He's going to give us grace. He's going to set us free. Praise God.